was knocked down, a hit and run by a speeding car. It's going to be a long struggle. It'll be weeks, months. I'm not sure when he will wake up.
So this will be a life-changing injury?
For him and for his family. This is his father, Anil Kumar. He's a daily worker. So if he's been here for 5 days. He hasn't been to work. But how many days he'll be off work? And as I said, he would need him as soon as he comes off the ventilator. He may be unconscious for months. He'll need to be with his son. And in countries like ours, rest of Asia and Africa, there is no rehab, neuro rehabilitation. So we have some physiotherapists. There are no speech therapists enough. There are no occupational therapists. The social services are lacking.
In terms of the trauma, the head trauma injuries that you deal with in this hospital, what proportion of them would you say are the result of road traffic injury?
I would say more than 90% of them. So there are many areas, like we're talking about children. 15,000 children die a year from road traffic accidents. It's not all of them were on two-wheelers. Many of them are just crossing the roads. There are no pedestrian crossings. There's no awareness that this is a school. Rohit is going to be here till he wakes up. He's off the ventilator. What happens after that? Because 3 months later, he may still be unconscious and he may be ready to go home. But unlike the Western world, there is no rehab center. So where would he go? And if he goes home in a one-bedroom house with four other people, who's going to feed him every few hours? Who's going to look after his personal needs?
Well, one of the things that we've been calling for is an international summit on child and adolescent health. Would you say that that type of event might help to focus international attention and national attention on the problem?
Yeah, because, you know, as I said, with people like Rohit, 80% of disabled people live not in the Western world, in the rest of the world. Mm-hmm. So there has to be, and in Asia and Africa, governments have to realize and should be given a helping hand. And unless there is a huge summit that brings focus on Asia and Africa and the injuries that are happening, somebody has to be responsible for taking that further.
Yeah.